Hey Grio fam, I'm Gerren Keith Gaynor, Managing Editor at TheGrio, and this is Grio Top 3, powered by the Dear Culture Podcast, which I co-host alongside Shauna Pinnick, Social Media Director here at TheGrio. And here at Grio Top 3, we give you the top 3 trending stories of the day. Coming in at number 3, ESPN's Rachel Nichols apologizes to Maria Taylor, but still gets the boot. ESPN host Rachel Nichols got the boot from the NBA Finals coverage after publicly apologizing on air to colleague Maria Taylor after assertions she made in 2020 were reported, in which she suggested that Taylor was given a prominent position commentating on the NBA Finals because she is Black. Earlier this week, Nichols started her show, The Jump, speaking to the camera saying, "The first thing they teach you in journalism school is don't be the story. And I don't plan to break that rule today or distract from a fantastic finals. But I also don't want to let this moment pass without saying how much I respect, how much I value our colleagues at ESPN. How deeply, deeply sorry I am for disappointing those I hurt, particularly Maria Taylor, and how grateful I am to be part of this outstanding team." In a now controversial leaked video, Nichols said, "I wish Maria Taylor all the success in the world. She covers football, she covers basketball. If you need to give her more things to do because you are feeling pressure about your crappy longtime record on diversity, which by the way, I know personally from the female side of it, like, go for it. Just find it somewhere else. You are not going to find it from me or taking my thing away." The video was sent to an internal server at ESPN where it was viewed by several people and circulated among African American staff members. Multiple Black employees of the Giant Sports Network told reporters the video is evidence that outwardly supportive white people speak differently about Black colleagues and issues behind closed doors. In an update first announced by Front Office Sports early Tuesday, ABC will be replacing Nichols with Malika Andrews as sideline reporter during the NBA Finals. "We believe this is the best decision for all concerned in order to keep the focus on the NBA Finals," officials announced. Rachel will continue to host The Jump. Talk about workplace toxicity. Let's just be happy that this was resolved and that Rachel is now taking accountability. Coming in at number 2 is some very sad news. The Parenthood actress Suzzanne Douglas is dead at 64. Suzzanne Douglas, the actress best known for playing opposite Robert Townsend on the hit 90s TV show The Parenthood, died Tuesday at the age of 64. Douglas most recently appeared in When They See Us as Grace Cuffey, mother of Kevin Richardson, one of the Exonerated Five. The film's director, Ava DuVernay, wrote on Instagram and Twitter that Douglas was a quiet, elegant force as we made When They See Us, a gentlewoman, a gem of a lady, a confident, caring actor who breathed life into words and made them shimmer. I'm grateful that our paths in this life crossed. May she journey on in peace and love. Douglas made guest appearances on countless TV shows over the years. On The Parenthood, she played Jerry Peterson for 5 seasons of the WB sitcom. Her character was a tough mom of 4 and law student wed to Townsend's character, a college professor, who lived with their family in Harlem. After Douglas's passing, actress Reagan Gomez, who played Douglas's daughter on The Parenthood, retweeted a previous note in which, responding to a question asking for all-time favorite TV mom, she answered, "This is hashtag Suzzanne Douglas Stan account." Gomez shared several pictures of Douglas, including one in which she lauded her natural hair, which was progressive in 1990s television. She also shared a photo of herself and Douglas taken during their last taping of their show. Suzzanne Douglas' acting career wasn't limited to the small screen. She appeared in the classic film Tap, starring Sammy Davis Jr. and Gregory Hines, earning an NAACP Image Award for her portrayal in the 1989 movie. She also starred in 1994's The Inkwell with Lorenz Tate and Joe Morton, which depicted the lives of Black families on Martha's Vineyard. Douglas leaves behind to mourn her husband, neuroradiologist Roy Jonathan Cobb, who she married in February 1989, and their daughter, Jordan Cobb, also an actress and writer. Suzzanne was a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated, where she served on the honorary co-chair of the Commission on Arts and Letters for 13 years, as well as a lifetime member of the Girl Scouts of USA, the National Council of Negro Women, and Sigma Alpha Lambda and Jack and Jill of America. Our deepest condolences to Suzzanne Douglas' family and loved ones. May her work and contributions forever be remembered. Coming in at number one, Sha’Carri Richardson is left off the relay team at the Olympics. Sha’Carri Richardson was not on the Olympic roster released by USA Track and Field, a decision that means the champion sprinter's positive test for marijuana will cost her a chance at running on the relay team in Tokyo, in addition to her spot in the 100-meter individual race. Richardson's positive test nullified her win at Olympic trials last month and the spot that went with it for Tokyo in the 100. Her 30-day suspension will end before the start of the relays on August 5th, which left open the possibility that she could win a medal as part of the 4x100 relay team. However, Sha’Carri's name was missing from the 130-person roster USATF sent out. The Federation had two discretionary picks beyond the top four finishers in the 100-meter final at trials, but chose not to offer a spot to the 21-year-old sprinter who was expected to challenge for Olympic gold. Asked about how Richardson was taking the news, her agent, Ronaldo Nehemia, responded, "We haven't spoken about it at all. It was actually not a topic we focused on." In a statement, USATF said it was, quote, "incredibly sympathetic towards Sha’Carri Richardson's extenuating circumstances, but fully agrees that international rules regarding marijuana should be reevaluated." Terrible news for Sha’Carri Richardson, but hopefully she can come back better and stronger in the next Olympic Games. This has been Grio Top 3, powered by the Dear Culture Podcast. For more episodes, visit our YouTube page. Go to thegrio.com for more stories, and be sure to subscribe to the Dear Culture Podcast wherever you listen to your podcast. Thanks for tuning in, and see you next time.